In the heart of every beehive, there's only one ruler, the queen. But she wasn't born wearing a crown. Out of thousands of identical eggs, only one becomes queen, while the rest grow into tireless worker bees. So what makes her so special? How do ordinary bees create royalty from scratch? Is it destiny, biology, or a bit of hive magic? Honeybees play a vital role in Earth's food chain by pollinating crops essential for both humans and animals. At the heart of the hive is a caste system led by the queen bee, the largest and only sexually developed female, responsible for laying thousands of eggs. Worker bees handle foraging, defense, and hive maintenance, while drone bees exist solely to mate with the queen. At the start, all bee babies are identical, tiny eggs laid in wax cells. However, the future queen stands out due to her diet. While most larvae are fed regular bee food, one special larva receives royal jelly, a nutrient-rich secretion produced by worker bees. Packed with proteins and sugars, this royal jelly triggers significant changes in the larva's development, making it grow larger and acquire the ability to reproduce. As a result, the queen becomes the largest and longest living bee in the hive. As the queen's role becomes clear, her development from a special larva to the leader of the hive is just the beginning. Once the queen hatches, her journey as the ruler of the hive begins. But before she settles into her role, she must first take a royal mating flight. This is a crucial step where she mates with several male bees, known as drones, and stores their sperm for the rest of her life. With this new supply of sperm, the queen's job is clear: lay eggs. And she does this with remarkable efficiency, up to 2,000 eggs a day. This ensures the hive remains populated with worker bees, drones, and, of course, potential future queens. But her duties don't stop at egg laying. The queen is also the chemical heart of the hive. She releases special pheromones, which act as signals to the other bees. These pheromones help maintain order in the hive, ensuring that no other female can develop into a queen. In a way, the queen isn't bossy. She's just biologically persuasive. Her chemical signals keep the colony running smoothly, guiding the behavior of worker bees and helping them understand their roles in the hive. The queen's power is in her ability to control not only reproduction, but the very essence of hive life through her unique chemistry. As the queen continues to fulfill her role in maintaining the hive's order, her reign, like all things, eventually comes to an end. As she ages, weakens, or dies, her pheromones will begin to fade within 12 to 24 hours. The moment the colony senses this change, worker bees spring into action. They select a few fertilized eggs, which would normally become workers, and feed them only royal jelly. Timing is crucial for this, especially for beekeepers, because if a new queen is introduced too late, the hive may reject or kill her because they've already begun raising their own. In a honeybee colony, there can only be one queen, and when she falls, the workers waste no time in preparing the next. In the hive, royalty is made, not born. With a dose of royal jelly, an ordinary larva transforms into a queen, shaping the fate of the colony. The queen bee's true power lies not in dominance, but in harmony with her workers, the hive, and nature's rhythm. Thanks for diving into the royal world of honeybees with us. If you enjoyed exploring interesting stories with us, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. What topics do you want us to dive into next? Let us know in the comments. Join us as we get animated about science here at Animated Science.